Well, I've been very lucky as a filmmaker because I've told a number of historical stories. But one of the things that I try to do in those historical stories is to make sure that they don't live in this kind of bubble of the past, you know? And after you see it, you say, oh, that was nice, but it has nothing to do with our lives today. And so we try to make films that resonate with the audience, and they say, wow, you know, I never thought about how that reflects on my life today. Freedom Summer obviously is part of our story today. It's about the fight for voters' rights in Mississippi in 1964. I think what you have to understand is that the civil rights movement had already taken off, but the general feeling within the movement was that you cannot go to Mississippi, that Mississippi was just too violent a place to go to, and you had to try to fight Mississippi from outside of Mississippi. Well, the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, SNCC, basically said, no, we're going to go to Mississippi. And they worked for 3 years within Mississippi, but they didn't get much traction. They actually got very few people to register to vote. And they came over with the idea, you know, let's bring all these college students there and draw attention to Mississippi, and maybe that would be a way for Mississippi to change. And so they decided that 700-800 college students, mainly white college students, would go down to Mississippi and spend the summer in Mississippi and try to register people to vote. So the story of Freedom Summer is really the story of three groups. It's one, the kind of activists with SNCC who were dedicated to the movement. The second group are the volunteers, which are mostly white college students who went down from colleges all over the country to spend the summer in Mississippi. And the third group that's really important are the Mississippi residents, the people who, black people, who took the volunteers into their homes. And that's where they stayed, in the black community. And in some ways, you know, they were the bravest group because they risked their lives during Freedom Summer, but after Freedom Summer too, they risked the retaliation of the white community in Mississippi. And when we talk about where we've come in the 50 years since Freedom Summer, obviously this country has come a long way. I mean, if you see the hate, you know, and the craziness that existed in states like Mississippi, you can't help but say, you know, we've come a long way. This country has changed drastically. But obviously, you know, there's more that we need to do. I think that's one of the great things about the United States of America is, you know, we have this ideal of the United States of America that's up here, but it's an ideal we'll never reach. It's like this thing that you're going for, and you can never get there, but that's the beauty of it, that you're always striving for something. You're always changing, you're always developing, and I think that's how the United States was set up, and we have to always remember that.